In this video, I'm going to show you how to have an object on your screen move when it's clicked. Let's take a look at the result. I have a jack-o'-lantern here. It's a P shape, but it could just as easily be an image file. I'm going to click on it. It's going to move until it reaches the end of the screen, and then it will redraw itself back at the beginning of the screen. And I can do that as many times as I want. This is going to become useful because we're going to have motion coming up. We're going to be creating a haunted house that will use sound and motion. And this is how we're going to have motion start and stop. So I've created a float X, a float Y, and a speed value. Here it's a float because if I wanted to make this slower, I can change the speed value and it will make it slower. I have a move equal to false, and this is a boolean, which is just a true false value because I want to see if it's moving initially. I only want it to move when I set that to true because I want it to hold still until it's clicked on. And then I have a P shape called Jack for jack-o'-lantern. So my setup is just setting my size and loading my shape. And again, you could do this just the same with the P image. And then I have my draw command. I've set my background to 0 and I've drawn the initial shape, setting Jack at the XY coordinates, which were 0 and 50. I'm checking to see if the mouse is pressed on the jack-o'-lantern. If that's the case, I set move equal to true. Otherwise, if you don't do it this way, if you just make it while the mouse is pressed, as soon as you release the mouse button, it will stop moving. So if move is true, I'm going to have it go through, because we're on a continuous loop with the draw, I'll keep redrawing the jack-o'-lantern every frame refresh by increasing it by whatever speed is. So I can make it significantly faster too. That's 0.5. I can increase it 5. That will be pretty darn fast. So speed is an effective way to control that. And so if it does that, we're going to keep going until X is greater than 400, though I could easily make that width, because I just want to check when it's off the screen. That should work exactly the same way. And if it is greater than width, I set move equal to false, so he'll stay put again. Set the background back to 0, set X back to 0, and redraw the shape in this spot so I can click it again. You'll be using this technique in your haunted house exercise.